Hello there, my fellow Inner Sphere historians, and welcome back to another Battletech lore video. I am not exactly sure how long it's been since the first video of this series, the one on Alexander Kerensky, but either way, today we shall continue our series on the famous characters of the setting. Now, first and foremost, I would like to say thank you to all of those who suggested other famous characters for me to cover. Many of your suggestions were great indeed, and I had to check through a few of them before settling on today's topic. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Fyodor Kurita, a famous leader of House Kurita and the Draconis Combine. Apologize if the pictures are mostly black and white, but do trust me when I tell you that we're lucky to have this many pictures of him to begin with. A lot of other famous characters barely have one or two. I'm your host, the Grimdark Narrator, and without further ado, let us proceed, shall we? In a nutshell, Fyodor Kurita was the coordinator of the Draconis Combine, the only child of Takashi Kurita and Jasmine Isu. He was born in 2997, and he died in 3070. The pregnancy of Jasmine was a difficult one. She was completely bedridden while having Fyodor, but did eventually recover after his birth. And thus, Fyodor was born on the 1st of July in the imperial city of Lufian in 2997. Because his mother knew she would never have another child, she lavished this one child with all the love she could give, in a fashion that was decidedly un-Kuritan. Although the coldness of his father would balance this out. When he was a boy, he was betrothed to a young daughter of a noble family. But when her father was discovered in a plot to assassinate Takashi, the entire family was killed. Fyodor began his schooling when he was 6 years old with his private tutors. He received mech warrior training at the Sun Zhang Academy, where Minoru Tetsuhara was one of the teachers, and then finished his military training at the Wisdom of the Dragon. During his time at the academy, he became friends with Subhash Indrahar, the director of the Internal Security Force. While he was stationed on New Samarkand, he was inducted into the Sons of the Dragon by Subhash Indrahar. Sometime during the academy days, Fyodor also fathered an illegitimate son with the Internal Security Force agent Kathleen Palmer. This child, Franklin Sakamoto, was taken away and raised in secret as part of a secret plan from Subhash Indrahar to secure an heir to House Kurita because Fyodor had rejected all the suggestions from Takashi Kurita. The day after graduation, Fyodor was presented with an ON-1K Orion as a personal battle mech. Incidentally, it was the refurbished Orion that was once piloted by the great Alexander Kerensky himself. In his early career, Fyodor served in a number of line units and as a staff officer, most notably as an aide to the Diran district commander Vasily Cherenkov. It was in the mid-3020s that he had a falling out with his father and was sent off to command the Legion of Vega, a brigade of misfits and malcontents. Fyodor resented this assignment deeply, as he felt it was preventing him from fulfilling his proper duties. By 3025, though, he was officially the Prince of Lufian and the heir designate of House Kurita. While he did not reveal it publicly, even to his father, until 3033, Fyodor married Tomoe Sakade in 3019, and they would have three legitimate children: Hohiro Kurita, who would succeed his father, Omiko Kurita, and Minoru Kurita. It was with the Legion of Vega that Fyodor began his programs for reform. He saw problems with the military doctrine of the Draconis Combine, notably their insistence on attacking the center of the enemy lines and enacting the right of seppuku by otherwise good commanders. Because of his leadership, the Combine was able to fight off the Lyran Commonwealth invasion of Vega during the Fourth Succession War. Later on, Fyodor exploited the machinations of Duke Aldo Lestrade of Sky and led a counterattack on several undefended Lyran planets near the regional capital of Sky. This action at the time forced Archon Katrina Steiner to use her reserve force, including the 10th Lyran Guards and the 1st Royal Guards, to counter-assault the Kuritan armies. After the 4th Succession War, Theodore's military acumen had become widely known, and so his father was almost forced into promoting him to the rank of Gunji no Kanrei, or Deputy for Military Affairs, in 3031. Takashi really wanted to rein Theodore in, but Theodore jumped at the opportunity to push his new interpretation of Bushido, which he began with the Genyosha and Ryuken units. Maybe the most brilliant move as Kanrei was agreeing to recognize the independence of the Free Rasselhaig Republic. In doing so, he bilked the Lyrans out of all the gains of the Fourth War and received aid from Comstar in the form of some new high-tech battle mechs. These mechs would also come in handy when the Federated Commonwealth launched their invasion in 3039. The War of 3039, however, was a brief affair. After Prince Hans Davion launched his invasion, Theodore mustered the forces for a counterattack, which then captured the factory world of Quentin. Hans would stop the assault in the face of the Combine's apparent power. And it wasn't until a decade later that he learned that Theodore's counterattack had only been a bluff, and that he had banked the survival of the Combine on Hans backing down. The 3040s were a peaceful period, but the 3050s brought news of a strange invader at the periphery. When the clans finally appeared, it fell to Theodore to organize the nation's defenses against what seemed at the time to be an unstoppable enemy. On Wolcott, he was able to trap the Smoke Jaguars, a plan executed by his son Hohiro and Shin Yodama. The Combine was able to obtain 4 operational Omnimechs at a time, another 2 dozen battle armor infantry suits, and a lot of salvage from the defeated Jaguars. Later on, Theodore traveled with the other leaders of the Inner Sphere to Outreach in 3051, for the purposes of a summit aimed at defeating the clans. It was there that Jamie Wolfe provided information to Theodore and the others, while he and Hans Davion agreed on a truce with the threat of a superior enemy. In 3052, the clans Smoke Jaguar and Novacat launched a joint invasion on Luthien. Hans sent both the Kell Hounds and the Wolf Dragoons to aid the DCMS units, which included units that followed both Theodore's reforms and the old ways which Takashi promoted. The victory by these disparate elements would help reconcile father and son, although successful brain surgery on Takashi also helped his mental state. Ironically, the clan invasion also helped Theodore's cause by giving so many of the traditionalist samurai the glorious deaths in battle that many of them wanted. Although father and son would find some respect for each other after these events, life in the Imperial Court remained uneasy. And then, suddenly, on September 15, 3054, Theodore's long power struggle with his father came to an end, as Takashi finally died. As the coordinator, Theodore vowed to focus on the clans and stay out of the politics of the Inner Sphere. He instituted the Phoenix programs, which were targeted at rebuilding the Draconis Combine military. To do that, he directed them to recruit heavily from non-traditional sources, such as women and Yakuza. He also allowed Comstar to stage Explorer Corps missions from DCMS bases, both within the Combine and the Deep Periphery, ostensibly with the goal of finding the homeworlds of the clans. On a more domestic basis, he initiated the Environmental Reclamation Program, a portion that transplanted 5,000 acres of trees to the vicinity of the Luthien continent of Aiki. Among other reforms, he also improved the trade and relations with the Outworlds Alliance. Theodore, though, could not keep the Combine out of the way forever, and then sent in peacekeepers under Comstar's aegis into the Chaos March shortly after its creation, mostly in the Lion's Thumb. Reactionary conservative elements within the Combine did not think that was enough, though, and invaded the world of Town in 3058. Although they were stopped by the mercenary unit Camacho's Caballeros, then they tried to assassinate Fyodor at his birthday. These so-called Kokuryukai were once again stopped by the Caballeros. The year 3058 saw the resurrection of the Star League and its goal of annihilating a particular clan. Fyodor argued that the clan should be Smoke Jaguar, because they were the most repressive of the clans towards their conquered peoples. Although the DCMS forces made up the bulk of the Star League armies, the Combine benefited greatly from the Inner Sphere Coalition that helped them. Fyodor worked on reintegrating the liberated worlds into the Combine, while other leaders went after the Jaguar capital on the world of Huntress. While those armies were gone, Catherine Steiner Davion usurped the last of her brother's thrones, and so Fyodor welcomed Victor Steiner Davion back to the Inner Sphere on Luthien. Afterwards, he was elected the second First Lord of the reconstituted Star League at the Second Witting Conference in 3061, after Victor cast the deciding vote against Catherine as the Precentor Marshal. Fyodor was accused of abusing his power as First Lord when he annexed the Lion's Thumb in 3062. In that same year, the Kokuryukai showed themselves once again when they hired mercenary units to attack Lyran units under DCMS colors. Similarly, these fake Lyran troops attacked DCMS garrisons. And when a real Lyran unit counterattacked, Fyodor seized the Lion's Thumb to ensure the stability of the region. In 3062, forces from Clan Ghostbear and the Federated Commonwealth's Draconis March attack the Combine. Fyodor received some unsolicited aid in the form of the Clan Hell's Horses, which attack the bears from the other flank, causing them to sue for peace. With one border secured because of the trial of Courchevel, Fyodor sent his units to beat back the nominally Fedcom invaders and conquered two more planets for his trouble. With the Fedcom Civil War finally done, the Fourth Witting Conference saw the dissolution of the Second Star League, which led to the Word of Blake launching their jihad on the Inner Sphere. Fyodor and his contingent had left Farkad before the attack there started, only to find their own capital being fought over by troops loyal to Fyodor and the Kokuryukai rebels, with the Word of Blake militia thrown into the mix. Unfortunately, while trying to direct the armies from Diron and plan a campaign to liberate Luthien, Fyodor suffered a stroke which rendered him comatose, and which finally killed him in 3070. His military reforms of the DCMS would later have to be backed down as well by Hohiro, his successor, to appease the hardliners who were still dominant in the military. And this, my friends, has been what I wanted to tell you about the famous Fyodor Kureta, the man who led the Draconis Combine for more than half a century through the clan invasion and a lot of other difficult times. I would also like to apologize if I didn't sound too great today, but it seems that my throat simply doesn't want to work today. I think we can say, though, that even after just this relatively short overview of his life, this guy did lead the Combine well compared to many other coordinators. Is Fyodor Kureta among your favorite characters of the rich Battletech setting? What do you like or dislike most about him? Was he a good leader, in your opinion? Whether you agree or disagree, do feel free to write your opinion in the comments below. If you found the episode informative or entertaining, please click the like, share, and subscribe buttons for future content. Thanks a lot for watching to the end, and I wish you an awesome and healthy day. This is GDN signing out.